In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, today let us reflect over the theme called Pride versus Humility. Let us reflect over the theme called Pride versus Humility. As we live in this modern techno-savvy era, as we live in this present scenario, human beings are tempted, and even human beings long to live a life of pride. It is true. Although we want to live a life of humility, but by attracting these worldly pleasures, by getting involved into these worldly attractions and worldly pleasures, we always live in the life of pride. At this juncture, each and every person faces the life of pride versus humility. Now, being as disciple of God, being as a worthy servant of God, you and I are supposed to live a life of humility. My dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we have a great personality who lived a life of humility. And we see true humility is clearly found in the personality of our Blessed Virgin Mary. We see Saint Augustine would say, humility is the mother of all virtues. Humility is the mother of all virtues. And we have a mother who is graciously and fully filled with the virtue of humility. I repeat, Saint Augustine would say, humility is the mother of all virtues. And we have a mother who is graciously and fully filled with the virtue of humility. She is none other than our Blessed Virgin Mary. We see in Mother Mary's life, she remains as a personification of humility. We see in Sacred Scripture, Luke's Gospel, chapter 1, verse 38, we consider her as something humble person because, Lord, let your will be done in my life. She said, Lord, let your will be done in my life. Be it done to me according to your own will, she said. And she accepted God's will with her humility and became the mother of God. And we need to accept, we need to acquire the same humility which Mother Mary acquired in her life. Let us examine ourselves, my dear faithfully in Jesus Christ. Am I ready enough to become and follow the life of Blessed Virgin Mary? Am I ready enough to accept and follow the life of humility? My dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we see, am I longing to become a humble person, or am I longing to become a proud person? In other words, am I seeking the will of God, or am I seeking the will of my family? It is true. Am I seeking the will of God in my life, or am I seeking the will of my family? If I seek the will of God, I am becoming day by day a humble person. Otherwise, if I seek, if I live a life according to my own family life, or if I seek the life of prideness, surely I am not living according to God's life. I am not living according to God's will. Rather, I am only living according to my own life, my own family life. Therefore, my dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we always need to live a life of humility in our families too. We need to seek God's help in our families. We need to live a life of humility with the unconditional love of God. We need to live a life of humility with the mercy of God. Therefore, we need to make a strong resolution that I always seek God's providence in my life. I always seek a life of humility with the help of God. That's why St. Bernard says, humility is the mother of salvation. Humility is the mother of salvation. And St. Teresa of Child Jesus rightly says, without God, everything is impossible. But with God, everything is possible. In order to make possible in our lives, in order to make a life of humility in our life, in order to eradicate the life of prideness, we need to live a humble person. And St. Vincent de Paul rightly says, my dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we need to live a humble life. We need to serve the poor people with the life of humility. When we serve the poor people with the life of humility, the God is going to bless us abundantly. The God is going to bless us, not only your own family, but even the generations to come. That's why, my dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we see in 1 Peter chapter 5, God opposes the proud people and he raises the humble people. We need to become more humble person, and we need to see the true humility is found in the pioneer and perfecter of our own faith in the life of Jesus Christ. We see in Hebrews chapter 12 verse 2, we have a Father, we have a merciful God, the pioneer and perfecter of our own faith, that is Jesus Christ. We need to live a life of humility by following the footsteps of our Lord Jesus Christ. We see the greatest humility we find in sacred scripture, as St. Paul writes letter to Philippians chapter 2 verses from 6 to 11. There we see Jesus Christ, though he was rich enough, he emptied himself and he was obedient, even death on the cross. That is the greatest humility that we find in the life of Jesus Christ. And John's Gospel chapter 13, we clearly see, it clearly expresses in foot washing. Jesus Christ washing the feet of the disciples. That is the greatest humility we see. And we need to remember one thing. Luke's Gospel chapter 18 says, we need to eradicate the syndrome of Pharisee, and we need to acquire the lifestyle of tax collector. We can clearly see the pride versus humility in the life of Pharisee and the tax collector. We should not cultivate the habit of syndrome of Pharisee. We must eradicate, we must remove from our lives. and we to have that syndrome of Pharisee, but rather we need to acquire the attitude of tax collector. Lord, forgive me. Lord, give me the aspect of humility in our lives. See, the Pharisee went to the temple and said, Lord, he is so self-righteous. He said, Lord, I am not like this person. I am not like this. He is making himself something self-righteous. I am good. I am correct. But if we see the attitude of the tax collector, Lord, forgive me. I am sinner. My dear faithful in Jesus Christ, we must always acquire the same humility like that of tax collector. Therefore, as we live in this present scenario, let us make a strong resolution that the Almighty God gives us the strength to live a humble life. When we live a humble life, the God is going to bless us abundantly. When we live a humble life, we are going to live a new life. For this, we need to detach our pride life. We need to say goodbye to our pride life, and we need to attach ourselves to the virtue of humility, the gift of humility. We have so many saints who lived a life of humility, and they remained in the history of salvation. They remained in the universal church as something great, as something an example life. And we need to edify ourselves from the lifestyle of saints, and especially from the life of Blessed Virgin Mary and our Lord Jesus Christ, the Savior. We need to follow him. Therefore, we need to make ourselves something great by following the footsteps of our Lord Jesus Christ with the path of humility. May God bless all of us. Amen.